We've seen a fair degree of a shakeout in the Indian startup ecosystem. We've seen a lot of money continue to come into the Indian startups ecosystem. And what I observe today is that there is a much more, there is seriousness about the business model, and there is seriousness about being able to chart out the path to profitability. So what would you red flag, and what would you be most confident about when we talk about the startup ecosystem?
So the red flag would really be continued access to growth capital. I think we, in the last decade, the foundation of risk capital has been fairly well laid, although a very small portion of that is from domestic resources.
Yeah.
But nonetheless, the risk capital and the understanding of it, the appetite for it, the curiosity for it is been a significant change from 10 years ago when I moved to India and started this to today, if I see. But you need links in the overall value chain to be tightly coupled.
Mm.
So the growth capital for these kind of new business models so far is almost non-existent from India, right? And so far that has been heavily dependent on external capital, right? And that external capital looks at a global framework in choosing their favorites.
Yes.
So that could be a potential risk, red flag to what we do. It could also be a potential opportunity, because the hope I have is over the next decade, we'll unlock the capital resources with newer understanding of these business models and enthusiasm for them, right? Which traditionally has not been the case. So in terms of what is interesting right now is in almost every sector, this concept of sort of, I look at it as a, what is the digital GDP that is getting created, and the digital footprint is so rapidly changing in how it's influencing every business model. And so the access, affordability, you know, of, and the target groups that are coming online is creating in every sector, very traditional sectors, even if you even look at very, very old sectors like agriculture, it is attracting venture capital investment and disruption led by that.
Do you see more consolidation in the space? And by that I mean more acquisition by global companies of Indian startups, the Walmart, Flipkart example playing out?
Yeah, I think, you know, for this industry, those are the headline news, right? But you need much smaller acquisitions, consolidation to happen well before it reaches that type of a scale. And that can only happen by having more relationship between, let's say, more bridges between India Inc. and the new age companies.
Yeah.
And that's something the bridges need to be still built.
Well, we're hoping that we're building that bridge here.